We're going to talk a little bit about something called flatting, and that's where we choose our local colors. And I'll explain a little bit more about that as we dive in. By the end of this phase, this is what your image should look like. You should have solid fills of color separating each element. And again, no shading or anything, they're just solid fills. Each element will be kind of separated that way, depending on how you want to paint things. But the mask is all one thing, the blaster is all one thing, backpack is on a separate layer. Everything is individual this way. To get to this phase, I want to talk about something that's super important. So before we even get there, let's talk about color palettes and how you get there. When you're determining the colors for your character, I want you to think about what kind of character is it? Different color palettes will help communicate a different type of personality. If you pick certain colors, it's definitely gonna feel like a villain. So I mean, looking at these colors, these Disney villains, and looking at these like deep purples and blues, you see a lot of these colors kind of connect throughout these different characters. But coming over to this side, where it's more of a heroic and sort of patriotic color palettes, you do see a little bit of overlap. Like if you look at Cyclops's old, the more kind of throwback colors that he had, they're not like Thanos. Thanos having these kind of purple colors, or at least with the lighting in the scene, the combination of colors and how you light the character, that's all going to help determine what type of personality your character has. These soft pastel-y colors fit well if the character is supposed to be in this sort of world, versus these more fun, playful, vibrant colors. I was somewhere around this palette, or at least inspired by this kind of retro kind of vibe. Moving in to the technical side of this, once you've determined, okay, these are the colors I want, or this is the color palette that I want to play around with, you would have had where we left off before, which is just your silhouette. It's important to have this main silhouette color. If you hold down Command on a Mac and click, you see the marching ants. It's important for you to have this shape because that's how you're going to trap all your colors inside of this. I'm going to show you real quick in this layer group how I did that. Here's my silhouette, and then all of these layers, you know, holding Alt and then click in between, it drops all of these layers. I did them one at a time, of course, like this here. You have everything titled. I picked a hard pressure brush, no soft edges, just something hard like this. All of this is set to 100 and no pressure. All of that's turned off because I just want to quickly fill in the colors. I didn't worry too much about this outside edge right here because I'm going to paint over that. Same thing with the eyes. Those are going to be on a top layer, so I'll go over that. And then for the black fur, again, this is over top. Make sure that I cover everything that needs to be white. So now when I go and grab my black fur, so with this, I'm taking a little bit more time because I want that to be crisp. And sometimes it might help to kind of turn those off and take a look. I know the nose is not fur technically, but it is black and it's going to be using a lot of the same color and a lot of the values and how it responds to the light. So I'm going to keep that in the same layer. And just so you can see better, created this gray. You see how this is rough around here? Now with the mask, it's important for me to be a little bit more careful because we're gonna use every little shape, every little layer when we start rendering this out and giving everything its shape and form. You can select, see this black fur? So see the way I painted over here? You could come over and then command shift click on the black fur, and now it has that selected, but I have my mask layer selected, and now I hit delete and then it deletes what's on the inside there. I create another layer and say call this backpack, and then here just start filling it in. You want to take your time with this. It is tedious, but trust me, these tedious steps is what's going to help you do a really good job. So yeah, so that's the process. I want you to go ahead and just kind of move throughout when you get to this phase and really get everything. Individual layers is very important. We're going to have everything on its own layer. And so once it's all filled in, you have all of these sort masked out. If you separate this from your silhouette, it's all messy like this, right? So what you want to do is you want to separate it. And then you want to click on this, again, command click on the silhouette layer with your backpack selected, hit inverse, and delete, and that cleans up your edge, and now you have your clean edge. And so you just do that with each one. Once you've done that, then you'll have something that looks a little like this. I click on everything, command click, and everything is separated into its own layer. I do hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments, please leave them below or subscribe to this channel. And if you want to learn more about this, check out my course on Domestika.